place. I embrace debate. I don't make mistakes. I just make my case. Drop spike when I'm done. What more can I say? Not bite to my tongue. I don't like the taste. I'm on in the morning. I own my phone. And I'm always in the zone. Need a zone out of zone. And then we can get it poppin'. Pick the topic. If you want to skip the shell, let's skip the happen. Took these sports and made them pop. All right. Undisputed.
Undisputed. We are live from Los Angeles. I'm Jenny Taft here with Skip Bayless and Shannon Sharp. Guys, good morning.
Good morning. Good morning. Good morning. How you doing, Skip?
I don't know. What is this?
I just noticed that.
Huh? Happy birthday, Go James.
It's Tiger Woods' birthday.
No, don't do this, Gil. Don't do that.
Sandy Koufax's birthday. He's the greatest left-handed pitcher in baseball history. Tiger Woods, Sandy Koufax, who's that?
Think about what you just said. Huh? You said the greatest left-hander. Yeah. But what about right-handed? Did they not throw right-handed? We're talking about the greatest basketball player of all time. The greatest golfer of all time.
Jenny,
I give you that.
Is it February 17th?
No. Wait, it is not.
Michael Jordan. Don't do that, Skip.
We're not there yet.
Have a day. One day out of 365.
I can't believe you made the sign. Yeah, you are very excited about this day, Shannon. So only appropriate that how about we do begin the show by saying happy birthday to the king, because Shannon's going to be throwing a party all day. LeBron James turns 36 years old today as his 18th season has just gotten underway. And to make Skip cringe just a little bit, Happy Birthday Goat has been trending on Twitter all morning. So, Skip, what was your reaction? You wake up this morning, you're ready for the day, and you see that this is trending on Twitter.
So, I wake up out here in Los Angeles every morning at 2 a.m. to get ready for this show. And the first thing I do is I look over at my little Maltese Hazel, and she's got one eye open like, are you serious? And I pull on my running clothes, and I start to stretch, and I take a quick look at my computer just to see if there are any late-breaking overnight stories and to see what is trending on Twitter.
We're trending.
And I wasn't quite awake yet, and I saw Happy Birthday Goat. And seriously, my first thought was, is it Brady's birthday today? And I said, no. That's August 3rd because that's Ernestine's birthday. And then I thought, wait. Is it Jordan's birthday? No, wait, that's February 17th. And then it hit me like 10 tons of bricks.
That's right.
The cult followers that I call the blind witnesses were at it again. They had this trending suggesting once again that LeBron James is better than Michael Jeffrey Jordan. That is the single biggest fallacy in the history of sports. I want everybody to let this sink in. LeBron James is 4-6 in the NBA Finals. Mm-hmm. Michael Jordan, once and forever, will always be 6-0 with 6 MVPs in the finals.
Did that.
And I cannot believe that the blind witnesses continue to try to scrub LeBron's legacy clean of all the epic fails that litter his legacy. Because they are too numerous to even detail here on this show today. We don't have enough time. Michael Jordan had 0 epic fails on his entire legacy, but LeBron had an epic meltdown against the Boston Celtics in his last series in Cleveland. His owner accused him of quitting in that series, and his camp tried to put out the story that he had to be sedated because of a locker room problem for games 4, 5, and 6, in which he basically disappeared in that series. Then how about the epic meltdown? The chosen one becomes the frozen one in his first finals with the Miami Heat, 2011, games 4, 5, and 6. Go look at the numbers and those. They stink. And then how about 2013, when Ray Allen saved his legacy after he came completely apart down the stretch in game 6 in Miami against my San Antonio Spurs, missed the tying 3, and then Ray Allen happened. And how about 2014, when he and his Heat lost the NBA Finals by a record finals margin? And how about game 1 of 2018 at Oracle, when he melted down at the end of the game and pouted and quit in overtime when they should have closed the deal, should have taken the last shot to beat the heavily favored Golden State Warriors. And I could go on and on and on, but here's the point to all this. LeBron James has convinced me He is simply the greatest self-promoter in sports history.
The man just happened to be born today, and now he's self-promoting it.
Hey, he is the self-proclaimed king. He is the phony goat, yet he has convinced billions of blind witnesses that he's actually better than Jordan, even after they watched The Last Dance, which should have convinced everybody once and for all that it was over. He's got the greatest publicity machine in the history of sports, and it's called the internet. It's called social media, and nobody has taken more advantage of it, used it better, more successfully, to dupe and deceive the public into believing that he's somehow the GOAT than LeBron James has. Way to go. Congratulations. Happy birthday, LeBron.
All The Last Dance did, Skip, was like, it's kind of like a trial. You get up and hear the prosecution. Oh, that Joe guilty. Oh, ain't no way he gonna get off on this. And then when you hear the defense, guess what, Skip? Oh, ain't no way he going to jail. That's all The Last Dance did. Wherever court, whatever side you was already standing on, you did not move. And that's okay. But all I'm saying is, my guy, happy birthday, Go James. Happy 36. Nobody has done it better. Nobody has done it better longer at this age than you have. Skip, at 36, he's in year 18. Do you realize that Michael Jordan was in his second retirement at age 36, citing physical and mental burnout? Do you realize that? That's what he said. Now, if it's a lie, he told it.
Not physical, mental.
He said physical and mental burnout, Skip. Now, first of all, LeBron James coming off his 13th NBA season, which he was first team All-NBA. Did you know Jordan had 10? So what happened those other years? He played 15 years. So what happened those other 5 years of the NBA? Did he not play?
He got forced out for 2 years.
Okay.
He had to take a forced sabbatical. That cost him 2 championships that would have been 8 straight.
Ain't no guarantee.
That guy is a guarantee. He's money in the bank.
Look, a lot of people believe, I believe, that he probably should have won his 5th MVP. He didn't give Giannis credit. His 10th final appearance in 17 seasons. Jordan only played 15 seasons. He went 6-5. The greatest thing that Michael Jordan has ever done is that he got knocked out before he got to the finals, so he has no blemishes on his resume. So in other words, people have convinced themselves it is better to lose in the first round, get swept in the first round, than make it to the NBA finals and lose, because that's what Michael did. Swept. 3 first-round appearances early in his career, got up out of there. My guy has never, ever tasted what it's like to go 1-2-3 Cancun after the first round of the playoffs. Your guy know what it's like 3 times.
Yeah, but your guy knows what it's like in the finals to get swept. See, twice with a gentleman's sweep should have been 3 times.
I'm glad you brought up the finals. Mm-hmm. Did you know it? I only went back 20 years. In the last 20 years, there have been 4 teams that have 4 all-star games, all-star players on their roster at a given time. Did you know LeBron James beat 3 of them? Mm. He beat the 2011 Celtics. I think, if I'm not mistaken, the 14 Hawks and the Pistons. The one that he lost to was the 18 Warriors. Jordan never beat that. Jordan never beat a team that had 3 All-Star, I mean, 3 NBA Hall of Famers on the team, Skip Bayless. Yeah, he did. He beat the Pistons. I give him that, but not in the finals. Not in the finals. That's what my guy had to go up against. Tim Duncan. Now, I want to know if Tim Duncan's going. Oh, as a matter of fact, he's going in this year. So Tim Duncan's going to the finals. Kawhi's going to the finals. Tony Parker's going to the finals. And Manu is going to the NBA All-Star.
You have consistently told me on this show that those Spurs teams were way overrated.
They're impossible to watch.
They're like eating broccoli.
No. I did not say. I said they are broccoli. They are boring. Mm. I didn't say they weren't any good. Mm. They were great. You don't win like they won. And just the fact that, Skip, each year, in order for them to get to where they needed to be, they